Dear students, in this session I wish to give a summary of Keynesian theory of income determination in a two-sector, three-sector and four-sector economy. Remember this, Keynesian model of income determination is a demand-determined model. Supply is assumed to be perfectly elastic. That is, economy is assumed to be operating at less than full employment. So whenever demand increases, only output and income will increase, prices will remain constant. So in the simple models of income determination, you will not see price. Price is absent in the model, or price is assumed to be exogenous, constant. That is a point which you must keep in your mind. This is because of the particular type of aggregate supply function assumed in the model that we have discussed. It is perfectly elastic up to full employment level of output. The second point is, aggregate demand in the two-sector economy consists of C plus I. In the three-sector economy, it is C plus I plus G. In the four-sector, it is C plus I plus G plus X minus M. In all the models, I is assumed to be autonomous. Autonomous or exogenous, independent of the level of income. Only consumption is autonomous, investment is assumed to be exogenous. The reason is that we have not explained what determines investment. Investment is actually a function of the rate of interest, and in the Keynesian model, interest rate is determined in the money market by the forces of demand for money and the supply of money. So to explain fully, the factors determining investment, we have to introduce the money market, which we do in the ISLM model later, not now. In the ISLM model, we will introduce interest rate as investment as a function of interest rate. In that model also, price is assumed to be a constant. So these two points should be kept in mind. You will not see price here. Investment is assumed to be autonomous. That does not mean that investment is autonomous. Private investment depends on the rate of interest. And we will discuss this point later. And when you move from a two-sector economy to a three-sector economy, always remember the changes which you observe in the consumption function and the saving function. Consumption function shift down or up, saving function also shift down depending on the taxes imposed. And as we have seen, the intercept of the consumption function is different with and without government. Also, the intercept of the saving function is different with and without the government. So this difference should also be kept in mind. If you start with a three-sector economy, remember this, your consumption function depends on disposable income, not depend on income. And we have developed three fiscal models. In the first model, we have considered only government expenditure and taxes. Transfer payments were ignored. In the second, transfer payments were also considered. In the third model, the head tax was replaced by an income tax and noted the difference in the value of the multiplier if the tax is a head tax. And in the last model, we have introduced the foreign trade multiplier and the change in the value of the multiplier in a closed economy and an open economy. Our discussion of the simple model is not complete as the role of money, monetary sector is not considered. The impact of price is not considered. And so many other issues are there. These expansions will be considered when we proceed.